11. Let's jump right into the problems for all of these. The directions simply ask you to write a linear equation in standard form. Okay, so here we go. Let's take this equation here and let's write this in standard form. Now, first of all, remember, step one, we want to simplify both sides completely. That's already done. Then move all the x and y terms to the left side. That's already done. And all the constant terms to the other side. So bring this over, make it a negative 3. And we're done with step 2. Now step 3 says eliminate any fractions or decimals. There are none, so we're finished. Simple, simple, okay? Alright, number 25. Okay, step 1, simplify both sides. Nothing I can do. Next, let's get your x term over here. Then your y term. And then your constant term stays over here. Simple enough. Lastly, eliminate any fractions or decimals. Okay? And there are none. Now, some teachers are pretty picky about the first term here. Well, first of all, your x term should always come first. If there's not an x term, then your y term comes first. And that's fine. But some teachers are pretty picky about your first term being positive. I'm really okay either way. So to me, this is an acceptable answer. The back of the book for their answer, for number 25, they have a positive 3x, a negative y, and a positive 8. So they simply went through and just changed all the signs. And that was their answer. I'm really fine with either one of those, okay? But do you understand, you know, technically speaking, the first term is supposed to be positive when written in standard form, but I'm okay either way, okay? Alright, number 27. Let's simplify both sides. Nothing I can do. Next step, let's get our x terms and our y terms on one side. So bring this over, make it negative. Bring your constant term over, make it negative. Next, eliminate fractions or decimals. I have a fraction here. My denominator is a 2. So I'm going to multiply the entire equation by 2. 2 times 3 is 6. 2 over 1 times 7 over 2. Your 2's would cancel, leaving you with negative 7. And then 2 times negative 9 is negative 18. And we're finished. Your x term is first. It's positive. Then your y term. Then your equal sign. Then your constant term. So we're good. 29. Okay, step 1, let's bring our x term over, make it a negative 5 halves. Your y term stays where it is, and your constant term stays on the right side. Next, we're going to eliminate our fractions by multiplying everything by 2. So, 2 over 1 times 5 over 2. Your 2's would cancel, leaving you with negative 5 x. 2 times y is 2y, and 2 times 9 is 18. Students, that answer there is totally acceptable, but if you want your first term to be positive, then you would write 5x, negative 2y, and negative 18. Okay? So either one of these two answers would be fine. Number 31. Okay, first of all, bring your x term over, make it positive. Then you have your positive y here. And then your 6 sevenths over here. So step 1 is done. Step 2, x and y terms on the left side, constant terms on the other side. Now, your denominators are 7 and 7. So let's multiply the entire equation by 7 over 1. 7 over 1 times 1 over 7 is 1x, or just x. 7 times y is 7y. And 7 times 6 over 7 would be 6. Alright? And you know you're finished. Your x term's first, it's positive. Then your y term, then your equal sign, then your constant term. So we're definitely good here. Alright? Number 33. Okay, now, first of all, before we can write the linear equation in standard form, we first have to simply write the linear equation. So we have a point, we have our slope. So here's the model I'd like to use. Y minus 1 equals m. X minus x subscript 1. Alright? Now, here's my y. So y minus 3. Here's my m. So 2 here. Here's my x, negative 8. So x minus a negative 8. Which of course makes it a positive 8. And now we would be done, except the directions said to write your linear equation in standard form. So step 1, simplify both sides. 2 times x, 2 times 8. X, let's move our terms around. Bring your 2x over, make it negative. Leave your y here, bring your 3 over, make it positive. And there we go. Now, students, for me, that's totally an acceptable answer. However, if you want the first term to be positive, then it would be 2x. Negative y equals negative 19, okay? Either one of those two answers would be fine. Number 35. Okay, first of all, let's write the linear equation. So I have y minus, and my y is a 4, equals m, which is negative 3, and then x minus x, which is negative 1, which of course, negative negative is a positive, and there we go. Now let's write this in standard form. Step 1, simplify both sides. So y negative 4 equals negative 3x. Negative 3, take your negative 3 and multiply it through. Next, bring your 3x over, make it positive. Of course, your y stays on this side. Bring your negative 4 over, make it a positive 4, and you're left with 1. And students would be your answer. Let me check that real quick. Yes, that is correct. A number 37. All right, here we go. I have y minus y. My y is a negative 2. And m, which is 5. And then x minus x, which is 3. And of course, over here, a negative negative makes a positive. Now to simplify, we have y positive 2. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times negative 3 is negative 15. Now let's write this in standard form. Bring your 5x over, make it negative. Your y stays on this side. Bring your 2 over, make it a negative 2, and there's your answer. Now again, if you don't want your first term to be negative, then simply change all the signs. Positive 5x, negative y, positive 17, and there you go. So either one of these two answers would be fine. Number 39. Okay, here we go. Y minus, here's your y, 9, equals m, which is negative 7, and then x minus spot on the left side. There's nothing I can do, but on the right side, take your negative 7, multiply it through, negative 7x, positive 14, negative times the negative is positive. And now let's finish the problem and write it in standard form. Bring the 7x over, make it a positive 7x, bring down your positive y, bring your 9 over, make it a positive 9, which leaves you with 23. Okay, so we're finished. Looks good. Number 41. Okay, y minus y, which is 3, equals m, which is negative 2, x minus x, which is 7. And now let's simplify this and write it in standard form. Y negative 3 equals negative 2x and a positive 14. Bring the 2x over and make it a positive 2x. Bring your negative 3 over, make it a positive 3, and you're left with 17. Okay? And that's it, guys. Not difficult. Pretty simple stuff. Alright? Okay, 45, 47, and 49. They are now going to give us two ordered pairs, and we're looking to write the equation of the line that passes through those two points, but we have to write it in standard form. So, soon, it's in order for us to use this model here. We're going to first of all find the slope, okay? So here we go. Y minus y. Here are your two y's right here. Over x minus x, which is 1, negative 5, or minus 5. Which would then give you negative 3 over negative 4, which is a positive 3 fourths, okay? So now we have our slope right here. Now, students, I've told you this so many times over the past 2 or 3 lessons, it does not matter which point you choose, okay? You'll get the same answer either way. I'm going to use this point here. So y minus y, which is 4, equals m, which is 3/4, times x minus 1. And here we go. Let's write this in standard form. 3/4 times x, 3/4 x, 3/4 times negative 1, negative 3/4. Now, bring this over, make it negative. Bring your negative 4 over, make it positive, and you're left with a positive 3 and 1/4, which is the same thing as 13 over 4. Now, we don't want any fractions or decimals. My two denominators are the same. They're both 4, so I'm going to multiply everything by 4. 1 times 3 over 4 leaves you with negative 3. 4 times y is 4y. And 4 times 13 over 4 leaves you with 13. Now, students, that is a great, perfect answer. I have no problem with that at all. If you don't want the first term to be negative, then you could write 3x negative 4y equals negative 13. Okay? And that's fine also. Okay, number 47, let's write the equation in standard form of the line that passes through these two ordered pairs. So first of all, let's find the slope. Y and y, so y minus y over, there's your two x's, is x. Negative negative is positive. That's 6 over negative 6. A positive over a negative is negative. 6 over 6 is 1. So there's your slope. Negative 1. Okay? Now pick a point. Doesn't matter which point. I'm going to use this one. Here we go. Y minus my y, which is negative 5 equals m, which is negative 1 times x minus x, which is 2. And of course, a negative negative here is positive. Okay? Now let's simplify. Take your negative 1, multiply it through. Negative 1 times x is negative x. Negative 1 times negative 2 is positive 2. Now bring your x over, make it positive. Bring your 5 over, make it negative. And you're left with negative 3. And that's your answer. Okay? Pretty simple. One more problem, students. Number 49. Okay, now in order to use this model here, we're going to have to find the slope first. So here's my y's. 0 minus 0. Here are my x's. 0 minus 2. So I get 0 over negative 2, which is 0. So my slope is 0. Okay? Now let's write the linear equation. Y minus y, we'll use this point here. Y minus 0 equals m, which is 0. X minus x, which is 0. If you take your 0, multiply it through, you just get 0. So y minus 0 equals 0. So really, bring your 0 over, make it positive if you want. Either way, you get y equals 0. And that's it. I mean, there's no fractions or decimals to get rid of. Your x and y terms are over here. Your constant terms are over here. So you're good. Okay? Students, I hope that this homework help video has been a help to you. If you have any questions at all, please don't hesitate